everyone, and a very warm welcome to WS Cube Deck. So guys, in our previous session, we have learned that what is XPath in our Selenium, in our HTML code, how to find an XPath. In our today's session, we will be learning that how we can click a button using Selenium. That means if you have any website and on a website, there is let it be any button. Okay, that means if you want to create an automation over there by clicking a button with your Chrome driver, then how we can do it, we'll be learning that in this video. So let's get started, guys. So I'll take a very small example over here. For example, let's just open Google and here, or I'll just open a new tab and let's go to any website. So let it be WS Cube Tech only. Okay, so I'll be going to WS Cube Tech. Here I'll be clicking on the first link. So once we click here, as you can see here that we are getting a website of our wscubetech.com. Now suppose if I want to click on any button, suppose if I want to click on explore courses, as soon as I click on explore courses, a new link will open in front of me, right? The same method, if you want to apply the same method using Selenium, that means if you want to create an automation where you want to make a button click on any website, then how we can do that, we will be learning that in our this video. So I'll just copy this URL from here, or before copying, let's start writing our code first. So let's go back here and let's import that from Selenium. We'll import WebDriver as we have learned before. So this procedure will remain same in all our videos where we will be calling our WebDriver so that we can automate the procedure, right? And here we will be writing from Selenium.WebDriver. Dot, which platform we are using is Chrome, so we'll be selecting Chrome here, that from Chrome dot service, let's import capital S service. I'll create a variable called as S. Inside this I'll be passing my path, so service, and in this I'll be passing the path. So the path would be this. This is the path of where I have my exe file of Selenium. Let's convert all the forward slashes to the backward slashes. Actually, all the backward slashes to the forward slashes, and then we will be writing our Chrome driver.exe. Once we are done with this, we will be creating a variable called as driver, not a web driver, but driver. Driver is equals to web driver dot capital C Chrome. Inside this, we'll be passing this service, and the service would be equal to this S variable that we have created. Now our driver is ready for the setup here. All we need to do is we need to write driver.get. As soon as I'll write get over here, that means the driver will fetch that website's URL. Now which URL we want to open? We want to open this wscubetech.com. So let's copy this from here. So I'll select all, copy it, go back to my program, and I'll paste it here. Okay. As soon as I'll run this, what will happen for me is very simple, that my driver will open, and here we have some internal server error on the website. Let's go for something else maybe, or let me just rerun it again. Okay, this time maybe it's working. So it's working this time. Now what do we need to do is very simple. Okay, still there are some issues. Maybe the website is down or something. So let's go for any other website. Let me just refresh it here. Yeah, it's taking a little while. So let's move to something else. Let me open any other website for you. For example, let's search for Tutorials Freak, and I'll open the first link that is here. Let's copy the website from here and let's go back to our program. Let's paste it here, and as soon as I run it again, a driver will open for me and it will load our website here. Now once I have reached here, I need to make any button clicked, right? So let's right click on it, let's inspect it, and as we can see here, only we can see a button of get started now. So let's go to our navigation bar, let's go to this. As you can see, we have a class called as button class, so we need to make this only clicked. So for that, I'll just right click over here, copy its XPath, as we have learned in our previous session that how we can copy the XPath. Let's go back to our code. And here we have to write driver dot find element by XPath, that we need to find this element by XPath. It's a button over here. And in the end, because I want to click this button, I want to create an automation where it will click it. So here we will write click. and let's try to run it. There may be some chances that there will be an error. What that error will be, I'll show it to you. So we have again opened our website. On our website, we have, okay, it didn't take a lot of time to load. That's why this error did not happen. And as you can see, it has automatically clicked on, I guess, what was the name of the button? So the name of the button was Get It Started Now. Yeah. So it has automatically clicked on this button. At times, what can happen, no, that suppose if we have any websites, if the website is a little heavy, for example, it has a lot of images, if it has a lot of videos, it takes a little while for that website to load. For example, the website of Twitter, or if we have a website of Instagram, it takes a little while to load because of the images and videos which are there. So in that case, what we need to do is very simple, that if your website is taking a little while to load, and Python being an interpreted language, it will not stop for us. It will start executing next lines of code. It will not wait for our website to load, right? So in that case, we will be importing our time module over here. What this time will do, time will basically give us a little time, give our website a little time to load on our driver. So for that, I'll be writing time.sleep. Maybe if a website needs maybe 2 seconds, so I'll pass 2 seconds here. And then I'll make the next thing work. That means I want to click on any certain element. So as soon as I run it again, a web driver will open on the same website. It will wait for 2 seconds. And after 2 seconds, it will click on Get Started Now. Once you have clicked on Get Started Now, you can make it click on any button here. So again, let's inspect it. And here, maybe you want to click on anything, maybe programming or anything, or latest technologies. Let's go for latest technologies. So here we have in our anchor tag, we have this latest technologies. Let's copy its XPath. So anything that is clickable, we can make Selenium click on anything that is clickable on our website. So we'll go back here. Give it a little while because now a new page is opening for us. So let's give it a little time to load. So time.sleep again for maybe 2 seconds. And again, we'll write driver.findElementByXPath. And here I'll pass this. Also, I'll write .click in the end with a function. So as soon as I run it now again, you can see here that a new website will open for us. After 2 seconds, it will click on Get Started Now. And again, after waiting for 2 seconds, it will click on Latest Technologies. And as you can see, we are on the Latest Technologies page here. That is Internet of Things IoT tutorial. Right. Okay. So this is how we can make anything click in our website. All you need to do is find its XPath. And in the end, you have to pass .click, which will make it click. So guys, this is how we'll be taking little steps towards automation. In our this session, we have learned that how we can make a button click. In our next session, we'll be learning about how we can take the input from the user. So as you can see, if I open this page and if I directly go to Google only, you can see there's a user input here where we can provide with anything we want to search for. So if we want to provide that, how we can do it with the help of Selenium, we will be learning that in our next session. So stay connected, guys, and I will see you in the next session. Thank you.